Hey, hey, Ninja. Today we are talking about how to fully remove a team member from Asana on the free plan. You may have noticed that it seems almost impossible to fully get somebody out of your Asana from the free plan. They just keep popping up in different places. So today we're going to remedy that. If you don't know me, I'm Misty Dorman from mistydorman.com and lifeninjatraining.com. I help overwhelmed entrepreneurs implement systems, strategies, tools, and tech to save time and mental calories growing their biz. If you want more of these types of videos, these types of tips, please leave your vote by giving it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe. It truly is the best compliment you can give me, and it helps boost the algorithm so I can reach more people with these tips. All right, so I won't keep you. Let's get started. So, as I was saying, it can seem kind of impossible to get a person out of your Asana if you're on the free plan. As I'm recording this, I don't know, maybe they'll change it eventually. It seems like maybe a hook that they use to get people to upgrade. So, first of all, if you are not using Asana, I will post the link before if you just stumbled on this video and you're not even using Asana, I'll post the link below for you to go check it out. But let me show you an example. So I'm just going to add a test task here. And if we look at this task, now I have taken this person off of my team. I've removed him from my team, but he's still there. So I've removed him from my board. I've unassigned him from everything, and he's still there. And so we need to fix that, right? We need to fix that. And the way that we fix that is it's a little bit of a funny workaround. You'll see if I also wanted to mention, let's see, like tag somebody. He'll pop up. Yeah. So we don't want that, right? We want to make sure that we clean up everything and get our old team members out of here. Maybe you work with different VAs and, you know, on different little projects, and they're not going to stay a member of your team forever, right? So the way that we do that, let me just move my face over here. Okay, you're going to need to create a new team. So you go over here on the left menu and just add a team. I've already added mine, and I called it Removing Previous Asana Team Members. Okay. And I've also included a description of this team so that later down the road, when I'm like, why do I have this team on here? I can know what this is for and how to use it, right? Because I don't need to do this task very often. But this is actually the forum post where I found these instructions, and I can paste this into the description for you so you could copy it right into your own Asana team and have this little blurb as well. But basically, when you revoke access to someone, you need to actually deprovision them. And if you had the person on your team where they're showing up like this, their face is right here next to yours, and you remove them from that particular team, it should give you the option to also deprovision that teammate. For me, in this particular instance, and this has happened to me before where I probably didn't know what that meant, or I just didn't even see that it was an option, and I didn't get someone fully removed. So for me, I didn't get the option because I really had only added this person to one project, one board, right? And so when I just deleted him off of the project, it didn't give me the option that I can remember to actually deprovision him. So what I'm going to do now, I'll show you how to do this. What you want to do is just add them to this board. Okay. Oh, that is the starting project. Let's type it in the right field. Let's see. There we go. Okay, and then this is actually going to send them an email letting them know that they have access to this team. So make sure that you name it something that makes sense, okay? Because you don't really get to customize the email that goes out or anything like that. If they ask about it, just explain that it's a workaround you had to do in order to remove them from all of your Asana, okay? And then you just send that. Okay, now this person is on my team. And now I'm going to deprovision them. Okay, so I want to go in and remove this person from my team. Okay, so I want to show you that it is actually locked out. If I go up here and go into the admin console, the members area and teams area, it's asking me to upgrade to premium in order to manage my members and my teams. Okay, so that's what we're working around right now, the fact that we can't do that. So to get around that, I'm actually just going to click this person's icon up here, and that allows me to do a little bit of management, right? So when I mouse over his name here, I'll get a remove option. So now I'm going to remove this person from this team. Remove access. Only choose this option if you want to remove him from all projects in this team. Remove access. And now, this is why I said I probably didn't ever notice this before I stumbled across this forum when I was trying to figure out how to do this. So right here, if this person should lose all access to your organization, deprovision. That right there, don't forget to click that. That's going to remove them from everything in your Asana. If that way they don't pop up anymore when you try to tag somebody or you're trying to assign somebody, you're not going to see them cluttering up your list anymore. So hit that deprovision button. Now you'll see the person was removed from my organization. That is what we want right there. So that's it. That's how you do it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. And if you need any more Asana tips, I will leave some resources below in the description as well. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. And I'll see you next time, Ninja.